So when we are talking about radiation or irradiation, there are multiple coefficients involved and you may get confused with them. So I also used to get confused. So there are four main coefficients involved, which is related to absorption, emission, reflection and transmission. So I'll give you the concept and a diagram so you can easily remember, and the logic will help you to recall it every time you want. So for absorptivity or absorption coefficient is given by alpha. The emission coefficient or emissivity is given by epsilon. Reflectivity or reflection coefficient is given by rho, the symbol for density. The same as the symbol for density. Right now it's the symbol for reflectivity. And transmissivity or the transmission coefficient, that is given by tau. So these are the four things which are involved. Now let's make a surface. So if we are given with a surface, that surface may be transparent, the surface may be translucent, the surface may be opaque. Opaque means we cannot it's completely opaque means we cannot look the other side from one side. It's completely blackout. Transparent means we can completely look the other side from the first side. Translucent means the visibility is not completely zero, not completely one. So in this, the visibility will be completely one. In this, the visibility is completely zero. In this, the visibility is between 0 to 1. In between. So we are given with a surface. And let's say the surface was at some temperature 0. Let's assume the temperature is 0. And it received some irradiation. So it received some irradiation. That irradiation is given a symbol of G. That's the convention. So irradiation is coming, that means some energy is incident on that surface and hence on the body. As per the properties of transparent, translucent, opaque, the values of these coefficients will change. But for sure, what will happen is will be described right now. Whatever is coming, some will be reflected back. So we have some reflection. Then the sum will be stored or absorbed. Absorption or stored. And sum will be transmitted to some other body. Transmission. Right? And after storing, there will be some part of emission. Since the temperature has increased, and the law for emission is that for any body which has a temperature greater than zero, since it has now absorbed some energy, it will reflect or it will emit some energy. So there will be some emission. So these are the four things. We had some radiation, irradiation, the body or the surface absorbed some energy, then it transmitted some energy to some other body, it reflected back some part of the irradiation, and after increasing the temperature it emitted part. So now the G was coming, the G amount was coming. Now we have the absorbed it, the alpha G amount has been absorbed, transmitted, so the tau G amount has been transmitted, reflected, so the rho G amount has been reflected with. And emission depends on emissivity and the black body emission power. The black body emission power again depends on the surface temperature. So the surface temperature can be TS. Now, since some energy was coming and some energy is reflected, absorbed and transmitted, that means if we add this all, which means rho G plus alpha G plus tau G, this addition should give me the complete G value. That means the rho plus alpha plus tau value is equal to 1, because this is the common factor, right? So this is the law. So this is some formula for it. And after all this we can have some energy which is coming to us, some energy which coming to the body, some energy which the body is emitting. That means the net heat transfer now by all radiations, whatever incident and whatever emission, all accounted for, all will be now A into emission into T raised to 4 minus Ts, T surrounding raised to 4. This surrounding temperature is because of this irradiation. Okay, so that's the net heat transfer by radiation. So we have cleared everything regarding radiation and irradiation and all the different coefficients which were involved, the surface. So this diagram is very important. In next video, we'll look at some questions to get some more clarification by solving problems and how can we use this formula. Okay, thank you.